While the search for more victims and burial sites goes on, we're learning that this process has been going on for quite some time.
KCRA3's Walt Gray is here now with new information about who was first contacted and how we got to where we are now. Walt?
Edie, Wesley Shermantine was set off when he found out that fellow murderer Lauren Herzog was getting out on parole. With the apparent motive of getting Herzog back into prison, Shermantine started talking. And now, dug from deep in the ground, we've seen the results of their reign of death.
It's been weeks now. Heavy equipment unearthing multiple bodies at various sites. Now, San Joaquin County Assemblywoman Kathleen Galgiani telling KCRA3 when Wes Shermantine started to reveal where the bodies were and to whom.
I was contacted in early January and informed that Wesley had asked to meet with retired FBI agent Jeff Reinick. And I contacted the Department of Corrections and I arranged for that meeting.
2 days after the FBI and corrections met with Shermantine, he revealed several locations where bodies were buried, as best as he could remember from 13 years prior. Shermantine also started reaching out to others, including bounty hunter Leonard Padilla. No matter what reason Shermantine had for coming clean, Galgiani is grateful.
I would thank him for what he's doing. I know that it takes some courage to be able to talk openly and to lead investigators, because he has other prisoners at San Quentin that know what's happening. They're watching this on the news as well. And I'm thankful that he's bringing relief to these families and allowing them to finally find peace and to move forward with their healing process.
Galgiani also told us discussions are underway to bring in FBI technology to speed up the search as families of missing victims wait to see if their loved ones are finally located. How many more burial sites and bodies remain? We simply don't know yet.